you know, is it that instantaneous forgiveness is a characteristic of pure devotion, and prolonged bearing of resentment is a characteristic of very low grade person? I would say yes and no. The scriptures give us verses when they glorify a particular quality, they glorify that singularly. But at the same time, if we do not contextualize these things, there can be a misunderstanding that may result. So yes, a pure devotee forgives instantaneously, but then we do see that the Pandavas did not simplistically forgive and let the wrongs which Duryodhana was doing go away. In fact, even Srila Prabhupada, he was extremely spiritually advanced person, and he was our acharya, founder acharya of ISKCON. But in Mumbai, when the devotees were getting a land from one Mr. N, and this Mr. N was a crook, and basically he was trying to, he took the money from the devotees and he didn't want to give the land also. So when the devotees were living on the land, he started sending hooligans to threaten them, and he started doing all sorts of nefarious things. So Prabhupada had 2-3 times talks with him, and then he basically showed his colors. Initially he seemed appeared conciliatory, but then he became so so evil. He revealed his evil colors, and Prabhupada was angry, and Prabhupada wrote a letter to one of the life members who was helping. Prabhupada said, I will not let this scoundrel Mr. N take Krishna's property even over my dead body. I will be the last person to give this body back to him. And so much so that eventually this Mr. N, he got a heart attack and he died. And then Prabhupada, what did Prabhupada do at that time? Prabhupada actually had the devotees prepare special sweets, and in the temple they distributed sweets on the occasion of the death of Mr. N. Now we may wonder, what is this? How can a saintly person do such a thing? But then Prabhupada was seeing that this person is opposing Krishna. So we cannot, especially when we are living in the real material world, you know, instantaneous forgiveness should not be seen as the only sign of devotion. Yes, it is definitely an important sign of devotion. And when there is reformation on the side of the other person, then there should be instantaneous forgiveness. And we see that many times in Srila Prabhupada's life also, when some of his disciples would do something wrong, and sometimes seriously wrong they would do, and Prabhupada would seem to get very angry. But when that devotee would apologize, so for example, this is a good point. Satsarup Maharaj writes at one point in one of his books, Living Life with the Perfect Master, that he used to take Prabhupada's letters dictation. And when he would take the dictation, he would at that time also type the letter and then mail the letter. So one day Prabhupada called him and he said, you know, I had sent a letter to one of his disciples, I think it was Brahmanand. And in that letter, I had mentioned, I am enclosing another letter. But this Brahmanand had written that there was no letter enclosed in it. So what happened? And Prabhupada was upset. He said, you know, what will people think of me? You know, what kind of responsible person is this? He's saying that I'm enclosing a letter, and I'm not enclosing. Wasn't it your responsibility to enclose that letter? Why didn't you enclose? So now, Satsarup Maharaj, he was quite a young devotee at that time, and he felt so upset. To please my spiritual master, he was devastated, not just upset, devastated. You know, to please my spiritual master is the goal of my life, and he's angry with me. Now what had happened was, that letter which was supposed to be filed by his previous secretary, that letter had not been filed. And Satsarup Maharaj had been searching, he couldn't find it. And then in the haste, he forgot that he had to look at that letter also. And this letter had got mailed without that attachment. So then he tried to explain it to Prabhupada. Prabhupada said, then you should have told me, you should have got that letter, or you should change the letter that I will send that later. How can you send it saying that I am enclosing the letter and not enclose it? And Prabhupada was unrelenting. And now Satsarup Maharaj felt so devastated, he started crying. And even when he was crying, Prabhupada did not relent. He said, how could you do such a thing? And now when he saw that Prabhupada was not relenting at all, he just broke down and went away from there. And Prabhupada just remained still angry, seemed still disgusted. And then finally he thought seriously about it after he calmed down. And then he came to Prabhupada. And then he said to Prabhupada, he realized Prabhupada's anger was not with him per se, was Prabhupada's anger was with the mistake. And he said, what I need to do is to rectify. So then he said that, Prabhupada, I'm sorry for this mistake. I will write to Brahmananda and I'll tell him that, you know, it was my mistake that I did not enclose. And then I will write to your previous secretary, I think it was some devotee, and I will get that letter and I will ensure that this letter reaches Brahmananda. And when he spoke this, Prabhupada smiled and all the anger disappeared. And then Satsuma says that, you know, he served Prabhupada for a long time. Prabhupada did not even give an inkling that such an incident ever happened. No, he had been so angry at one moment, and afterwards he did not even talk about that incident and did not let their relationship get affected in any way by that. So he says that when we commit a mistake, we should do three things. That's what he learned by this interaction from Srila Prabhupada, with Srila Prabhupada. That first is sincerely seek forgiveness. Second is do the necessary things to correct the consequences of that mistake. That means, you know, he said, okay, I'll send the letter, I'll get that letter and I'll attach it. And third is make sure that you don't try your best to make sure that you don't repeat the mistake. So this is practical. So that means why I gave this comment, I am not contradicting the scriptural verse which says that a pure devotee forgives instantaneously. I am giving this example simply to make out the point that sometimes even a pure devotee may seem to be angry, and we should not think that if a pure devotee is angry, that means this is not a pure devotee. So forgiveness is definitely an ornament of a pure devotee, but the primary characteristic of a pure devotee is dedication to Krishna. Krishnaika Sharanam. That is the primary characteristic of a devotee. That the devotee is completely surrendered to Krishna and will do whatever it takes to serve Krishna. And if a person is obstructing Krishna's service and is not ready to change the ways, then becoming angry with that person and punishing that person and